The Interactive Elements IGT walks you through the testing of your interactive elements names, roles, and any applicable states. Let's go ahead and get started. To begin, it's highlighting the 7 interactive elements it could find, and it's asking if there's anything that was missed. Next, it captures a screenshot of each interactive element, asking me to select which ones I'd like to test. By default, these are grouped intelligently, which uses our AI as well as other heuristics to group similar elements. We can also group by role, which will take the calculated role for each element and group accordingly. Let's focus on this advanced settings button today. First, it asks if the accessible name and hint advanced settings accurately describes the element's meaning. Next, we're meant to select the role which accurately conveys the element's purpose. Finally, we can take a look at the element's states. So right now, this advanced settings is in the collapsed state. And in fact, the tool has confirmed the same. But what if we want to test the expanded state of the advanced settings control? Well, we can actually use this new test another state for this element control. So I'm going to go ahead and expand my settings button and have it check again. Unfortunately, it looks that the expanded state is not being properly conveyed. So I'm going to inform the tool that this element is in fact in an expanded state. So in that 1 minute, we were able to find one accessibility issue. And let's take a deeper look at that issue. So here, for the expanded state of the advanced settings button, it's actually generated a dynamic recommendation to fix for the specific issue based on the information gathered in this IGT. So it's telling us to replace the re-expanded equals false attribute with the re-expanded equals true. So why don't you go ahead and test out your interactive elements and let us know what you think of this new IGT.